Hallo, ik ben Pam en ik wil graag een hele mooie warme kleur in mijn haar die mijn gezicht nog mooier laat uitkomen.
Ja. Yeah. This Pam and she wants to have almost the same hairstyle because we're going to do it with a hot knife and we give her a wonderful warm color because now it's a different shades and we'll see what happens. Pam, will you turn for you and the rest of the world to show how your hair is now?
Yes.
Wonderful. Okay, thank you very much.
Thank you.
Hello friends on YouTube. I'm gonna do Pam's hair. And what I'm going to do is first I'm gonna wash her hair. She has a lot of hair, thick hair. But I want to wash it before I'm going to color it. I'm gonna color it with a soft color. Just not with a high peroxide in it. And I want to get it in the most wonderful condition she can have. So first I'm going to wash it and then I'm back. For cutting. Okay, I'm back and we washed the hair with the detox of Kin because there was a lot of silicone based products in. Now the hair is totally clean. I put a little bit conditioner on the ends because it was a little bit dry. Now I'm going to protect her, of course, for cutting. Use also a neck paper. And sometimes people ask why you do this, but this you do because everyone has a clean cape. So you don't have to be worrying about how clean the skin is, but laying beneath it. And it works very clean. So that's why you do this. Now I'm going to brush the hair with Tangle Teaser. And I use the splatch. The nice thing about splatch is that it goes deeper into the hair. And you can use it while you're showering or washing your hair. You can still feel that the ends are totally dry. But it's just the upper layers. And she wants layers, so that's not a problem. Well, look at now.
Pam.
Ja, in het Nederlands is Pam. In het Engels is Pam.
Ja. Als je wilt in het Engels praten, kan het ook hoor. Ik weet niet of het de bedoeling is.
Oh, je mag Engels praten als je wil. Maakt mij niet uit. Ik kan ook voor Nederlands praten.
Oké. Okay. Het fijne van deze borstel dat je er echt helemaal niets van voelt.
Nee. Het is speciaal ontwikkeld door een kapper voor zijn dochters. De dochters hadden lang haar. Die zaten altijd iedere dag te beulen. Met hun haar. En die hebben tegen hun vader gezegd dat ze niks ontwikkelde voor dat. En dan gingen ze hun haar afknippen. En die vader wilde dat niet.
Nee.
Want die hadden heel mooi lang haar.
Ja.
En die is toen die borstel voor die meiden gaan ontwikkelen.
Ik ben heel blij dat hij dat heeft gedaan.
Ja, mooi hè.
Dat hij zo onder druk is gezet.
Die zijn een hele leuke uitvoeringen.
Mm-hmm.
Het is allemaal dezelfde prijs. Nou, deze pakt toch de eerste. Het is allemaal dezelfde prijs.
Je hebt zo'n hele standaard.
Nee, dit is veel fijner, want je polijst ook je haar. Het wordt gelijk veel mooier. Laten we zien wat we hebben.
Al je gear.
Hè?
Al je gear.
Ja. De toolbox.
Yeah.
Now, what I have is, I have a grown back side shape, because it's now growing till chin line. Then I have layers in it. But the layers are not the way they should be, because they're not connecting to each other.
Nope.
I have a total short part on the front, and this comes from the area behind the fontanelle, and then I have long hair laying as a plank on the back. So that I'm going to correct. For the rest, she has wonderful hair.
Thanks.
And she comes from Amsterdam.
Yes.
Thank God we have Amsterdam.
Kom je vaak in Amsterdam?
Nou, regelmatig. Om gewoon te wandelen en zo. Ik vind het een leuke stad om gewoon te kuieren.
Waarom heb je eigenlijk niet daar ook een shop?
Een vriend van mij werkt in Amsterdam.
Ja?
In de Jordaan. Op het randje van de Jordaan. En die zit in een shop waar je stoelen kunt huren. Daar ga ik binnenkort een keer werken. Maar laat
ik
wel weten.
Ja, want ik kan me voorstellen dat je echt superveel mensen hebt die zich nog geïnteresseerd zijn nu.
Ja, maar in New York zitten de meesten.
Ja.
Now I'm going to work with my hot knife, because that's the best tool I can use on her. I'm going to work in the lines
of her facial lines. I know I want to keep the length at the back. And I make a moon shape with my knife. This knife is 190 degrees. And it seals the ends. Just gently go in. Knowing that she wants to keep the length. So here's the guideline of the back. The next line I will show you from the side, so you can see what I'm doing. Set out a new line, 2 centimeters of hair. Come to the front. Taking the hairs up. Now watch at the chin bone on her left side and follow that line. Bending the hairs in the right way using the skull as a guide. The nice thing about working with a hot knife is that it don't pulse on the hair.
But it smells like my hair is on fire.
Yeah, but it isn't, because it's wet. It smells a little bit like working with iron on clothes.
Yeah. It's like a barbecue on my head.
Now take a part of the front. So this is the part that should be the bang, but I never go into the bang with this hair. And now I make a slight curve in the hair to get a pass to the other side. Now I watch at the chin line on the other side and make my first line. Of course this side is a little bit thinner because the side shave has to grow back. Take some hair on it. This I do to get on the bending of the head. Now come on the fall of the head. So straight on the center of the skull. Lay there again in the roundings. And gently take off the ends. Now go to the back.
What?
The size. Start over the skull bone. Take the upper side.
Is het nou ook zo dat de onderkant echt veel lichter is?
Ja, en droger. Veel droger.
Hoe komt dat? Dat daar
zo? Ja, geblondeerd geweest, hè? Now bend her head a little bit to the front. I have to do because I want the hair straight down and I want even this hair to stay. Otherwise I have a curve in it and then the under hair will be longer than the upper hair. Go to the half. And make the same line as the chin line into her hair. So this is the same line as I have as a chin line. It's also the same line as I can see on the back of her head. Do this on both sides. Take it to the center and take off the dry ends. Control it once more. So this line is that line and this line is that line. And so I connect all the hair. Now I come to the spot where the connection was wrong. You see the layers I made are here, and this part hangs like a curtain down
and has no shape at all. So now I take it over her skull, bend it in the shape, in the moon shape, take it to the front, knowing that I did the midsection, and take that part off. So I get a wonderful new line and a lot of movement in it. And of course she has this on both sides, so I do this on both sides. Now I parted myself a rounding on her head. So I started behind the fontanelle, take the hair up in a rounding, and this I give a little bit more effect, because then I can make a more playable layered hairstyle. Take the hairs down, and just with the tip of my knife I go in. This I can do with a hot knife because it stays closed for more than 6 months. So there is no damage at all, but it gives a playable effect upon her hair. Just gently go in, not taking length, but just a little bit, make it a little bit thinner so it is more playable. And this one I took out. But now I have a playable effect, and I'm certain I have all the layers cut. So also that the parts that were shorter, I have them also. So now I can make a collar.
Yay.
Leuk. Ik was vergeten.
Ik mag het niet kort doen, ik mag niks scheren. Ah, ja. Dus ik denk dat ze heel blij is.
Wie weet hoe surprised mama nog gaat zijn. Hè?
Precies. Ze had het over dat ik geen paars
in. Die zegt tegen die kapper, zei tegen mij, houd van mij als knippende vader. Dat is leuk voor je moeder.
Dat zou ik doen.
Oké, okay, meter color, a meter infinity color. I used 453. That's a choco brown, a nice warm choco brown, because it's end of autumn and it's starting to get winter. And in winter time, you don't have to worry about the colors. I worked with the one part color, one part 6%, and one part deep conditioner. So I made the 6% is 20 volume back to 10 volume, so I have no damage at the hair at all, just glow and healthy hair. The nice thing of that is that it don't gives the inner structure of the hair a different shade. So when we want to go to a blonde color, what we are talking about when you're not looking, then I know that I can get this color easy out of the hair because it's not built up. On top of this, I will take some hairs that are in the color and give it some highlights, and that I lay on foil. But first I apply in the same line as I did cutting, by parting part by part, the color on the hair. Now I lay the hair in a natural fall, and I take some hair up, just some small parts in the upper length, just to give it a little bit highlight, not too much, but just on the color. I will lay it. I use plastic foil. Lay it beneath it. Lay the colored hair on it. And I made a Goldwell bleach with 6%. It's 20 volume. I didn't apply anything on in it to get rid of the natural colors, because I just want to give it a playable effect on top. Don't make a hard line on the start. And so I lay some color on top of her hair. Okay, now I have some highlights on top, just in the colors she has, because it lay in the color. And now I'm going to close the plastic foil. We wait for 25 minutes and then we're back to show you the end result.
Ik ben wel, zeg maar, geïntimideerd door al die hoofd achter me. Ik
denk
van,
ja,
nice.
Kijk, hello friends, we are back. Color is off. We took without heat 30 minutes, and now I'm going to blow dry her hair, and afterwards I'll make it a little bit wild because she lost wild hair. I used from Hathaway a smooth product because I want to get some moist into the hair.
Ooh, smells nice.
Yeah. Most professional products smell nice. It's one way to trigger the customer. Comb this product through the hair. Start blow drying with a large brush. The nice thing is that the highlights are not visible in wet hair. They come out when the hair is a little bit dry. Part it in the same way as I did with cutting. Over the skull bone and start in the neckline. I take this large brush and I start blow drying in the neckline as I told you. But if you have to watch till it's dry, it's very boring, so I stop the video now and come back when it's almost dry.
Oeps.
Ja, dat moet, ik moet nog een keer groot scherm hebben.
Ja.
Ik moet gewoon even opnieuw.
Hammer.
I hold her hair in the most natural way I can. And afterwards I will make it a little bit more wild, because she loves wild hairstyles. And that'll do with a Dirty Angel. It's also a product of Rove Hair. And I'll show you how to use that at home when you have long hair. The hair feels wonderful, it's natural, soft. And it's a wonderful glow, and the highlights are just wonderful, soft on top of it. So I don't, from the side you can see it, I don't know with this light if you can see it, but they're laying on top and they're just like the sun is shining into her hair. So far blow drying.
It's very soft.
Now I make photos with this hair, so I don't do anything in it, and then I will put a Dirty Angel in to show you how to use that.
Lijkt er wel lekker aan.
Ja, gewoon nu zo.
Ja, mag je even zachtjes een rondje draaien. Mooie glans erin. Hair is wonderful shining, wonderful of structure.
It feels so nice.
It's always nice to have good hair.
It is.
Okay, make photos of this and then I'm going to show you Dirty Angel.
This is Dirty Angel. You have to shake it well because there's a little thing in it. And it's a dry shampoo with styling product. So now she throws her hair to the front.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Okay.
And then in the underlines, she just put in a little bit of this spray. It roughens the hair a bit. And it's also nice when you don't wash the hair that much. Now you can throw it back and just shake it.
Wah.
And then you see that the hair is a lot wilder, because this is a wild hairstyle. You see that it's jumping up other sides. So I show you this also in photos. But then you have a wild hairstyle. Thank you for watching this video.
Thanks.
We gaan nog foto's maken.
So cool. It's echt heel nice.